guys, welcome back. Today I have a digital drawing time lapse for you guys, and I felt like talking about a art topic this time rather than just general updates on how comic stuff is going and such, even though I love doing those, and I'm sure I'll do another one next week. But yeah, this time I have a topic that I have been thinking about, or that happened to enter my mind, and I figured it would be interesting to talk about. And that was the question of, do you need a unique or recognizable art style if you're an artist? Because obviously it's a very common desire that most people have, right? You want to have your own style that everyone can tell it's yours, and not be just one of the bunch drawing the exact same kind of thing. And you know, everyone's like worrying about it, especially if you haven't found quote unquote your own style yet. It's like a thing that can cause a little bit of distress even. And yeah, I was thinking, like, do you need one? And obviously the answer very quickly became pretty much no. Like, you can point out probably dozens and dozens of people who have very common art styles that are like very trendy and popular, who, you know, they make a good amount of money without being that unique. And there's a lot of people with very unique art styles who don't really make a whole lot of money for various reasons. So yeah, that's what we're gonna be discussing today. And before that, let's just mention a little bit about what I'm drawing in the background. It's one of the bonus thingies for the back of the book, book 3 of my comic. And for those who don't know, I'm Minna. I make a webcomic called Stand Still, Stay Silent, and I'm working on the third physical book printing for it, and this is one of the things for bonus content. The comic pages themselves are already drawn, obviously. I'm up to like book 5 now, as far as comic pages go, but yeah, I've just got to get them printed. And the subject is, remember the summoning of Coco thing that happened in the part where they were fighting all of the little creatures that the horse face brought with him? You know, that scene? I felt like we needed a page where I give you guys the translation of the spell. A lot of people have been asking for that, the same way that I had a translation for one of the early spells that Lolly used. So yeah, that's what this is gonna be. There's gonna be text over it, but this is gonna be like the background thing for the text. And yeah, that's what I'm working on, and let's get back to the discussion. So, unique art style, do you need it? Answer, no. And I guess we're gonna talk a little bit about like the pros and cons of having a art style that is recognizably yours. I guess one of the obvious pros of having a popular common style is in like the industries of art, and by that I mean like getting hired by studios, because in those cases usually art directors and like magazine art people and whoever does the hiring for artists for products or projects, they don't really look for something different. They're usually looking for what's popular or whatever the art director feels like they want for the project, and it's not like they're going for weird new styles or anything. They want to do what's trending and what they've seen around, and they probably have like a image board or an idea board of these are the styles that we like. Let's find an artist who does this style. And if you're an artist who happens to be doing, for example, an illustration style that is very popular, like for let's say children's books, you know, there's if you go on Instagram and search for children's book illustrations hashtag or something, usually what you get, you can kind of see what is the popular style, and a lot of them are looking like they could be drawn by the exact same artist, and that's for a reason. It's what's popular and what sells and what people are getting hired for right now. And if you have like a really weird style, or not even weird, but just not a trendy style right now, that it's pretty possible that you wouldn't be hired as easily, because you're not what people want right now. Like, your book wouldn't maybe sell as much as one illustrated by a person who does a very normal, in-hip style right now. And the same goes for, like, if you want to work in video games, there's kind of, you know, those typical concept art styles that, you know, kind of all look the same, and they wouldn't want to hire someone on a team who draws completely differently with a strange cartoony style, when everyone else is doing the standard concept art style, you know? It would just be confusing for the cohesion of the project. So, you know, in those cases, just being very good at what you're drawing but not having a standout look at me kind of style is gonna be helpful for getting work, right? So yeah, that's like a plus one for having a run-of-the-mill, oh, that's also negative, popular style. Let's just call them popular styles, the ones that are not that unique for one artist. So that's one up for the popular style. I guess on the flip side, if you're going for, I guess, your own kind of path kind of artist, where you're hoping to sell artwork or prints, or maybe get like a Patreon supporter following or any other kind of following online for your art specifically, and, you know, make money from it, I would almost say that it's more beneficial in those cases to have a recognizable art style. Because on one hand, if you have a popular art style, it might be easier to get like the initial boost in followers, because, you know, people who already like that art style are just gonna automatically follow you, because they're like, oh, it's this art style that I already like, neat, let's follow another one who does it, and, you know, you get followers. But then when it comes to selling stuff, I mean, you're going to be competing with maybe dozens of people who are basically drawing the exact same thing that you are doing, in the same style that you are doing. And, you know, who are they going to buy a print from when it's Christmas time and they want to buy some art prints as gifts? They might not buy them from you, because, you know, there's a bunch of other ones that they already follow and who are maybe a little bit better than you. And they don't really care that it's your art, they just want the style for it, right? But if it's like your art has a specific special style that everyone wants because it's your art, then, you know, you're gonna be selling way more prints than the popular style artist. Except in cases when obviously the popular style artist is like the big dog of that style, you know, one of the originators, because obviously there's usually, especially on like social media and Instagram and stuff, usually each style has like their original person who kind of started it and made it popular. Yeah, if you're that person, obviously you're gonna be the one selling the most, probably. But you're most likely not that person. So, you know, in that case, it's probably better to have, you know, maybe a smaller following, but with the people who do follow you actually being interested in your unique style rather than just following you because you draw the same way some other person does. Because in that case, they might just want to get the print from the other person, right? Yeah, so I think the going your own way with your art, being a independent artist who isn't trying to get hired by other people, then it's probably better to have a unique-ish style to some degree, right? And what else would be like a situation where one might compare? Comics, I guess? I mean, I'm in comics, and I guess, honestly, I feel like art style, as far as having a very unique art style, isn't really that much of a thing in comics. Like, it can help, obviously, if you have a very cool art style, like in, let's say, American comics. I guess superhero-ish comics. You know, I don't really care about American superhero comics at all. I'm more of a European graphic novels and manga kind of person. But, like, I will always recognize the art style of Mike Mignola, I think he's called. He does, like, Hellboy and stuff. And his art style is very recognizable and interesting and cool. But then all of the other ones, like, if you showed me any art from any Marvel or DC artists, I can't tell them apart. Like, sometimes I look at their art and they all look the same to me. They might have little differences and maybe some of them are considered to be better than others, but see, they all have the same, you know, in-house American superhero style. And yeah, like, if I wanted to buy an art piece from any American style comic person or want to get like a graphic novel, even though I don't care about the characters, I would go for something that Mike Mignola has done, just because I recognize his art style and it's interesting and unique, right? But on the other hand, as far as reading comics, usually people care about the characters and the story more, right? Like, the art style can be an eye-catcher and bring people in the way a good cover for a book can bring people in. But the thing that actually gets your comic to have staying power is the story and the characters, right? And how good you are with storytelling, or humor if you're doing a humor comic. And it's more important, I would say, than in illustration. Because in illustration, you know, there's a level of storytelling, of course. The illustrators who are able to tell stories and convey emotions a lot usually tend to do more impactful work. But on the other hand, a lot of illustration is just about looking kind of pretty and making people feel good about looking at it, even though it doesn't necessarily convey anything. I mean, so much art is just paintings of beautiful things without a story to it. Just a person looking with a relaxed facial expression in the distance, you know? And they are very popular with a lot of people. So you don't really need as much of a story with illustrations and stuff. But with comics, yeah, like, the storytelling is gonna be outweighing the stylistic choice a lot more. Especially if, like, the art itself is good, it doesn't really matter if you're, let's say, copying the art style of Sailor Moon or something. Just completely. Like, maybe people are going to call you a copycat, like, oh, can't you get your own art style? You're just copying this and this art style, but as for long as your story is different, it's not going to be a detriment, right? Well, if you're doing illustration and you completely copy someone else's style, I'm pretty sure people are going to call you a copycat. And even if you do like something a little bit unique with it, you always kind of run that risk of being just a style stealer? What's it called? Art style thiever? Oh, you know what I mean. You know, you always run the risk of getting mowed down by overzealous fans, or in even some unfortunate cases, even by more popular artists who will call you a art thief. Oh, that's what I was calling. No, wait, style thief. I don't even know what I'm saying. Anyway, you get the point. Doesn't really matter that much in comics, is what I'm thinking right now. Let me know in the comments if you disagree and that, like, having a unique art style in comics is a deal breaker for you, or are you fine with reading comics that are kind of just nice looking and not that different, I guess, you know? This was mostly, you know, my opinions and stuff, more about thinking, and yeah, I guess just letting people know that it's not the end of the world if you have a art style that isn't that different, you know, you don't need to worry about it, you can just take your time and enjoy what you're drawing without having to force a different art style if you enjoy what you're doing. Obviously, if you do want to try developing a unique art style, nothing wrong with that, but yeah, I would say I've come to the conclusion that it doesn't matter that much. Everyone just draw what you like in whatever art style you happen to like, I suppose. Anyway, that's my rambles for this week. I will see you guys next week for something else, some other drawing, some other talk and stuff, and read my comic if you haven't yet. It's free to read over at sssscomic.com. I make 4 new pages every week. It's a Nordic post-apocalyptic adventure comic, set like 90 years in the future after a horrific pandemic has wiped out most of humanity. And there's a bunch of monsters and horrific mutants around, and the Nordic mythology woven into the whole stuff, and that's it. I'll see you guys next week. Hope you enjoyed the drawing, and bye bye!